interesting. Starting a fire in the library. I don't suppose we have any. No. Quick save. Okay, let's try this door then.
A simple test. That's settled.
Hey. Right.
Durance? Don't close it, go in. The Vault of Forgotten Thoughts. Hmm. Everybody, right? Interesting. Like a living prison, thick arms of coral have grown around an assortment of old, weathered relics. Durance has discovered something.
Now what the flame
it's
has
here.
Shown us?
The salt well.
In the room is a pool. It's small, but deep enough that you can't see the bottom. The glassy surface looks almost frozen. So does Maneha. She stands rooted in place, staring at it.
You know, I thought it'd be bigger.
Looks deep anyway.
Gift bearers say the heaviest regrets and greatest sorrows get left here. So it better be.
She peers in. I thought you'd be diving in by now. Maneha makes a little noise of frustration in the back of her throat. She didn't like that?
You know how when you've been thinking about something so long, you're worried that when you finally get it, it won't be what you expected?
Mm-hmm. The hype. The hype, man. She tugs at one of her bracelets.
I mean, for all we know, that thing's just filled with leeches.
You're stalling.
Don't remind me.
Which one should we choose? You were never liable for the massacre. Let go of your guilt. Your memory of the massacre has shaped you. Discarding it may change you more than you intend. True. Would she, like, would the person she becomes slowly change because that's not... You know, or would she change right away? Because the events that, yeah, it's a good question. Like, say you're, because of things you've gone through, say for instance you're a negative person, and, you know, see the bad and everything, and are very cynical because of what you've gone through in life. So you, this memory is wiped, just like that. Either way, I think you become less cynical, but would it happen over time? Or right away, cynicism gone? I think it would happen over time. I mean, it's a habit, still. Even though the reason is no longer there. It still shapes who you are now. Yeah, it's a good question. You have no right to forget the massacre? What if you're prevented you from committing a similar crime? Your suffering helps no one. Your problem has never been your memory. It's the part of your soul that led you to massacre those people. Last one is really impatient. It's curious, yeah. Your memory of the massacre has shaped you. Discarding it may change you more than you intend.
Good.
She takes a deep breath and closes her eyes.
Anything's better than this.
Then do it. She lets out a long, slow breath.
Okay. Here goes.
She shakes her arms and legs out with a jingling of metal. Striding forward, she steps into the pool. We're going to lose our companion. What if she no longer
wants... That's cold!
Yeah. What if she no longer wants to be with us because she's not inclined to anymore because she's a different person? She convulses with a sudden shiver, rattling her jewelry. She descends the steps until she's standing in water up to her neck. Do you feel anything?
I think I'm going numb, actually.
She shivers again. I'm asking her what year it is. Or I wasn't. I was thinking about choosing that.
This is the right pool, isn't it?
She frowns and cranes her neck around the room. My requirement's not met. Well, Aeloth has a good lore score, but I guess I'm not... He's not talking to her. I am. Maybe you need to get your head in the water, too. She gives you a very... a wry, sidelong look. Then she takes a deep breath and submerges. A minute ticks by. Two. Maneha still keeps herself... Maneha keeps herself still beneath the water. At last she breaks the surface, wiping the water from her eyes and shaking it from her hair. Sorry about my voice, guys. I have no idea what's going on.
Hey, gift bearer or not, don't think I won't pull you in here, too.
Wait, you said gift bearers don't come here. Maybe you have to leave something behind. Like in the book. Her eyes go wide and she snaps her fingers. The bracelet?
I've got it!
She digs through her pack and produces a thick bundle of cloth bound with leather. It's the same bundle you glimpsed earlier. She snaps the leather cords and unrolls the cloth, revealing a wine bottle.
Took this from the Marchezo cellar the night I awakened. Been saving it for a special occasion.
Maneha cradles the bottle and brushes dust from the green glass, heaving a sigh. She swings it by the neck and smashes it against the steps. You could have offered me a drink first. Maneha drops the rest... Ooh. Getting red. Drops the rest of the broken bottle into the pool where it spirals into the depths. Meanwhile, the wine has formed a roiling, bloody cloud in the water. The wine. Is that what I said? It spreads in long, swirling tendrils. What is that? There's a baddie in there. The surface of the pool ripples and Maneha paddles at the spreading cloud. Crimson tentacles erupt from it, writhing and reaching. Maneha gasps as one wraps around her arm. Well, she's paddling, but she's actually standing in there. I don't know.
Stand back!
Grab Maneha. You reach for her just as another wine-colored tentacle wraps around her head. She shouts as it pulls her under. Oh no! I try to grab her. Aeloth grabs your arm and pulls you back before you fall in too. No! I like her. She's cool. Maneha disappears into the pool. You can't see anything through the crimson murk. Except for the blossoming cloud of wine, the waters look perfectly still again. The seconds crawl by. Well, we've got to do something.
What are we just standing here for? Help her!
Well, you help her. You're closest. At last, bubbles break the surface. Maneha emerges, gasping and shivering. Yay! Her face is strangely slack and her eyes are bloodshot. Are you alright? She thinks about this for a moment. She nods. She's not speaking. Maneha climbs up the steps and out of the salt well. As she does, the reddish color dissipates from the water, leaving only the glassy clear surface and the unfathomable depths below. What do you remember? She squints, thinking. Water pools at her feet.
I remember running, but I don't remember what chased me. And I remember fear, but I don't remember what scared me.
She looks back at the salt well. Well, what would you guys do? Would you guys tell her to do it or not to? I figured she wants to. She's a free person. But I'm not sure what kind of Maneha we're dealing with right now.
I gave something up, but I don't remember why.
How do you feel? And I'm also not sure if this is what she had in mind. She tilts her head to one side and wiggles a finger in her ear until a spurt of water streams out.
I'll feel better after a glass of wine.
Something drips onto the floor. She holds her right arm up and looks at the trickle of blood running from a cut in her hand. She takes the folded cloth, the one she'd wrapped the wine bottle in, from the floor and stanches the bleeding. So what was this tentacle thing? Maneha was granted clean conscience. She jerks her head towards the exit. Well, we got a lot of experience. We found the salt well and Maneha surrendered her painful past to Andra. It may be too early to understand how this truly affects her. True that. True that. No, that's so weird. I don't know.
Lead the way.
Yeah, get out of there. Okay, we're trying to get this thing. An urn. Gwyn's Band of Union. Cool. Ring of Unshackling. And 2 rubies. Huh. Grants Blessing 1 per encounter. Grants Instilled Doubt when endurance drops below 80%. Plus 4 intellect. Foe AoE days for 2 ways. That's pretty neat. I like that. Excuse me, guys. Throat noises. Gwyn was a young woman from Forked Vale who was engaged to be married to a farmer from her village. Her parents were thrilled about the match, yet as the day of her wedding drew nearer, Gwyn suffered from horrible nightmares that she was suffocating. She would awaken, gasping for breath, but otherwise unable to move. She told her parents about the nightmares and the horrible weight that seemed to press on her shoulders more and more each passing day. They assured her that the nerves would pass, but they didn't. On the morning of her wedding day, when the sky was still gray and a heavy mist hung over the fields, Gwyn snuck away. She thought a long walk might calm her, but the further she got from Forked Vale, the better she felt. By the time she reached Pearlwood Bluffs, she realized she had no intention of going back. She spent the night at a little roadside inn on the charity of the owner, and after a hot dinner and a good mug of ale, she enjoyed the best sleep she'd had in months. When she awoke, her hostess pointed her to Defiance Bay. She reached the city and quickly found the port. She had nothing of value besides her betrothal ring, which she traded for passage to a deer. I kinda like that. When your endurance drops below 80%, I guess that automatically happens. Days for 20 seconds. Pretty neat. Good, like, get out of jail spell. Yes, I like Gorn's Pledge. Deflection. That's pretty neat. Suppress Affliction is great. Ring of Deflection. Yeah, give it to her. I'm kind of thinking Aloth, but... If I give it to him, it will increase his area of effect, duration, and his will for his spells. I think I'm gonna... We'll see how it works out. deflection. I think he really needs a deflection, I don't know. I don't think we're going to be using this crap. Can I... to that. Bloop. Cool. Sneak mode.
Time to see and not be seen.
Cry secrets. Yeah, those tentacles are pretty scary. That's the god, or is that Andra herself?
I can do that. That's settled.
Saint Weigelt's Cudgel. Plus 5 accuracy, inflicts persecuting for 6 seconds on a hit. I don't know what that is. I can't mouse over this. Persecuting? A strictly devoted follower of... I forget what's... Wutica, I believe it's pronounced. Weigelt was haunted by dreams of criminals committing horrific acts of violence, only to escape punishment to receive one that was unduly light. She came to believe Wutica was speaking to her through these dreams, demanding these people receive justice. Weigelt found these criminals in hideouts and homes, and very often in jail, serving inadequate sentences. She would steal into these places, which were frequently under heavy guard, find her way to the criminal, and pronounce the judgment of Wutica. Her incredible knack for reaching these places were in some instances later declared as miracles when she was canonized. If the criminal was lucky, it would only mean disfigurement, but most were executed on the spot with Weigelt's cudgel. Eventually, Weigelt's reputation spread too far, and many criminals that feared her began to set traps and issue bounties. When she was finally caught, she was clubbed to death with her own weapon. It is said that with her final words she declared that she was a murderer and that she deserved this fate. St. Weigelt's cudgel is a simple spike club with a leather-strapped handle. The wood itself is irreversibly stained reddish-brown with the blood of criminals. Into the stash. I don't think that went into stash, did it? Maybe. It doesn't say I went into the stash. I don't see it, though. Maybe I'm blind? I just don't know. Alright, I don't know. It's not in there now, so... Oh, don't close that. Oh, the door opens both ways? Where'd that go? Oh my. Well, these are the Halls of Silence. Okay. Well, I don't want to sign off in this place. I was about to. Let's attack these guys, I guess.
Let's go!
Unless we're sneaking, we gotta announce our presence. Let's go!
This thing isn't doing the job.
Alright. Call to arms! Oh, we planned poorly though. Alos in front. Alos, would you go back here? Too late for Durance. Although we'll knock this one down. Ow, man! Can we knock him down? He fell so quickly? And why is Adair running back? Wait, no. Yeah, raise him. He can't move, can he? I can't seem to move him at all. I'd love to, believe me. Okay, go. Alright. Sunder them. Alright, this guy. Now that he's finally free, cast that. I've been neglecting Alos because I'm trying so hard to get him out of there. Boom. Maneha. Punch. Want to attack Durance. Good. Just cast on yourself. Bouncing ball. Bloop. Nice. Oh, chunkage. The Halls of Silence aren't that silent. Exceptional sword. Large shield. Potion of Wizards double. Lockpicks. Money. Fleet feet.
Sure.
That wasn't that bad. It was more than... wasn't as much as I thought there was. He got rice, this guy. Fine pistols. Alright, sneak.
Oh, and if I find something good, you can have half.
Oh, there's something over here. Oh, just oil and gold rat shoe? I'll take that. Okay. So... gonna camp here. I need... what do you call it? Stuff. Okay, thanks so much for watching, guys. Gonna sign off here. See you next time. And Ender. And Endering. Go strong.